Okay, we back in the Bronx. You guys love that line. Unfortunately, we are here with another story similar to the last and others before this. Today's story takes place in Dub City. Now, we had did a story back in the premature days of this channel, which detailed Dub City during the early YG's, YB's and the OG's times. We will only briefly discuss that history here, because we will go more in depth on that timeline in another video. Just for a scope of things, here is a map of Dub City, only the Dub. If you know, you know. Here you can see that Dub City stretches roughly between 175th and East Burnside, between Jerome and Creston, Morris, whatever. However, the name Dub City, the Dub part of the name, represents Walton Avenue, the main strip. At one point, their territory stretched further than this, but allegedly, an internal dispute caused a split between them and the guys from the down the block on Walton. Those guys referred to themselves as Dub TG. It was said that Dub TG stood for Walton Townsend Gangsters, which Townsend being the neighboring block, but if you know, they went by War Town Gangsters. Townsend is a block over from Walton. They had hood stars out there too. The guys is, like Nah Boogs and Zeb Live were known on the Get Light dance scene, but jumped into the streets and criminal aspects later on. Tay and Quay Dollars were beloved members from the area. Quay was a member of the Mac Bowlers and was also popular on the dance scene, definitely an innovator and influential in his time. He did have ties to French Montana's Coke Boys. You can't say French hasn't helped in the Bronx, facts. And he is still trying to put other young people on. Anyway, during the times of the split, Quay Dollars would stray away from Nah Boogs and the guys from the lower part of Walton, Dub TG, and side with the upper part of Walton, which is Dub City. Again, we will go more in depth on these times in another video. Dub City was in a war which involved the 280 Crips and 6 Wild, the other groups in the area at the time. The streets will mark this as a legendary time. Also, we believe that there was some static with the Eden Boys. We will do more about the Eden Boys soon. Now, there has been murders up until current time in these areas in general, and we will have to get back to Mount Eden to give insight. But to sum it up, Dub City has had its share of wars, alliances and enemies. They beefed with Burnside, BMG, a crew that suffered greatly from an indictment in 2013. The original guys have moved on, so it seems. Dub City used to have a YB presence in the area, and some of the older guys from Dub City honor Noah Bowler's name as well, a member of the OGs. Not sure if they jacked OGs or not for a short time, but they did have an alliance with dudes from court. That's what brings us to this story, and this guy. He is alleged to be a member of both Dub City and the Mac Bowlers. This is the guy alleged to be responsible for the murder of Brandon Hendricks, aka B.Diddy, or Diddy, a beloved member from Courtland. Once a rising star on the basketball court, Brandon Hendricks Ellison's untimely death sent shockwaves throughout New York City. At just 17 years old, he had already made a significant impact on his community in the Bronx and beyond. His potential was cut short, leaving behind a promising future. He had played ball for Monroe High School, which is located close to Bronx River Projects. It was said that Diddy was handsome, talented, smart and caring, and excelled not only on the basketball court, but in geometry class as well. The city mourned his loss at his funeral on July 15, 2020. Vanessa Gibson, then a city councilmember, reflected on his life, saying it was difficult to grieve someone with such promise. But the memory of Hendricks Ellison was not forgotten, instead, it was celebrated. On July 7, 2021, a street in his neighborhood was renamed Hendricks Ellison Boulevard, ensuring his legacy would be forever embedded in the borough. To further honor his memory and support aspiring students from the Bronx, the nonprofit organization OAID Group established the Brandon Hendricks Scholarship under the Bronx Rising Initiative in 2020. The scholarship, exclusively for college-bound high school seniors, aimed to provide financial aid and opportunities for talented students like Hendricks Ellison. Despite the tragic circumstances surrounding Hendricks Ellison's death, his legacy continues to inspire change. His former basketball coach, Nigel Thompson, praised his character and condemned senseless violence. Brandon Hendricks Ellison's story, though brief, left an indelible mark on the Bronx. As the holiday season approached, Eve Hendricks found herself surrounded by bittersweet memories of her beloved son, Booby. Her Bronx apartment, adorned with pictures and life-size cutouts of Brandon, served as a daily reminder of her profound loss. The holiday season was especially challenging, with the void of Brandon's absence feeling unbearable. Despite the support of family and friends, Eve hoped that her son's story would inspire change. She wanted people to remember him not just as a victim of violence, but as a bright and promising young man. Diddy's name has been immortalized through music. These days, crews are naming each other's dead friends. Ever since Chicago started dissing deads, it started an unprecedented level of disrespect. Some of these drill guys are not even that talented, but just brazen enough to mention deads for shock value. Sometime the same people out here smoking deads become a pack themselves. We have seen it multiple times. Bop has added to the end of a victim, which are dances imitating the fashion in which someone was killed. We have heard the Diddy Bop, as well as Naughty Bop. Some of these guys haven't even finished high school and can barely read. It starts at home, with the parents. Sadly, even the parents who want the best for their children, the ones who didn't lose their lives to drugs, sometime work long hours, leaving the children unsupervised. It is what it is though. On June 28, 2020, just before midnight, police responded to a 911 call about a male who was shot in Morris Heights in the confines of the 46th Precinct. When cops arrived on Davidson Avenue, they found Hendricks with a gunshot wound to his neck. EMS personnel transported him to Saint Barnabas Hospital, where the teen was pronounced dead. Shortly after Diddy's death, police release a picture of his alleged killer. Police wanted to question 22-year-old Najhim Luke, who they said has brown eyes and is about 6 feet tall and 140 pounds. A little over a week after the murder, on July 6, Najhim Luke was arrested and charged with murdering the 17-year-old college basketball prospect. According to the investigation, at 1726 Davidson Avenue, the Najhim fired shots at a group of people who had gathered for a barbecue. That's how Diddy ended up getting hit. Word on the street, Najhim didn't pick a target, he was just shooting, so this is not a OGs versus Walton situation. Seems more like wrong place wrong time, especially since it was said that Dub City had no beef with the OGs from Courtland. As for Najhim, he also faced raps for allegedly attacking his relative in June, in the days leading up to Diddy's death. In addition to being charged with Diddy's murder, Luke was hit with assault and strangulation raps Monday for two incidents involving his uncle. One in which he struck the older man in the face with an unknown object on June 10, and the other June 22, when he put his hands around his relative's throat. Luke lived with his uncle on Walton Avenue in the Bronx. The slay suspect also was previously arrested in November 2014, when he was 17, for allegedly joining two cohorts in beating a victim before swiping his black Gucci belt. But this about wraps it up for this one, and as always, stay low and thanks for watching.